You've graduated. You have nobody to question you. You can do whatever the heck you want to do. You can live wherever you want. And now you have so many other responsibilities because you have to pay rent, you have to pay your own bills. Welcome to something that's called being an adult. Guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are staying safe and staying indoors. Today is the final episode of my three-part series. If you haven't watched the first two parts, go right out and watch those first. Where first I talk about my entire process of applying, second I talk about my experience with Alam College in depth. For the third part, I'm going to be talking about my life after graduation. As you all know, for my Alam degree college, I did a master's in fashion marketing and it was just like 1 year course. It is very advisable to start your OPT planning and start putting all your forms and everything right at the starting of your capstone. OPT means you get 1 year. For Alam, the OPT was 1 year. A lot of places the OPT is for 3 years because you're a STEM course. You're allowed to work full time with the company and gain experience. Once you have your OPT form filled, it goes to government and you get your final CVS portal where you can log in and keep a track on your EAD card, which means employment authorization card. So I was also doing my capstone. I started applying for jobs because I think it's more advisable. I always saw that right out of my college, I'm gonna get my first job, everything's gonna go perfectly, which to be honest did not happen. But when I was doing my cap, I also was interning at David Yurman as an e-commerce intern. I also applied with like nervousness and I never thought in like a million years that I would get this, but I applied for my dream company. And when it comes to luxury brands, it's Louis Vuitton. I applied for this job that I saw on Louis Vuitton's portal for e-commerce coordinator, and I just applied and I totally forgot about it. I applied for other jobs and everyone, but to my surprise and shock, I had an email from Louis Vuitton which says Louis Vuitton opportunity, and of course it's like the rejection letter. I remember I just like walked past my roommates, I went into my room, I locked myself and I was crying that Louis Vuitton even thought that they can hire me, or like they even opened my resume, they even opened a person, like they have thousands of applications, hundreds and thousands of applications, they even opened and responded to me. That was like a crazy thing. So I was like, of course, on cloud nine, and the first round of course was like a telephonic interview, and for the next round I was set to interview with like the manager. She wanted me to come in and interview with the director of e-commerce, and I was like, that's it, I got my dream job right out of college. How is this even possible? Like, I was counting my lucky stars. I'm like, how is this even possible? Getting a job right after college. But that joy didn't last very long because EAD card is the worst thing. Until you get your EAD card, you are not officially allowed to work or even intern. The catch here is, when you apply for your EAD card, there is a wait time of 3 months before you actually get your card. It is always advisable, if you're gonna graduate in August, which I did, to have your EAD card date as like the last date. So basically, once you finish classes, once you start your open, you have 90 days in the States to find a job. I couldn't start my job until October, and this is August that I'm talking about. And of course, no company is gonna wait for you until you get your card because they have other people as well. Yes, I had to let go of my opportunity with Louis Vuitton just because of an EAD card, and till date it hurts me so bad that I was so close to getting a job offer by my dream company. Sending it out in the universe that anytime I get an opportunity to work with Louis Vuitton, at Louis Vuitton, like I would just love to work with them, like work with them, work for them, because that brand is pyar. Once you're like almost on the verge of like graduating, there are so many seminars and so many workshops that you have to attend, especially as an international student, because there's just so many documents that you need to take care of. And they give you like a tracker, which is like a tracker on Excel. Even you can make it, or you can search like online. LinkedIn is literally your best friend, and get that premium account because that is so helpful. this is not sponsored because you have so many other features. Like you can see how many people are applying for this job, how many skill sets you have that match this job, and how likely is the recruiter going to like get back to you. Also, you have the opportunity of sending in mails. That is, like you can send a mail to the HR directly through LinkedIn, which is great. In the beginning, I would agree that I was very finicky about the brands and the companies I wanted to, because I knew that my aim after graduating is to work for a luxury brand and for a job in marketing. And I say never be stuck on something, because destiny and God always has a plan for you, and it will not work out until you reach that position that God wants you to, and then everything will work out. And why would I say that is because I was so head on, like just applying for like marketing jobs, marketing coordinator jobs, e-commerce coordinator jobs, that I completely like looked past other opportunities in digital media. I completely looked past like other things, avenues like PR and brand. That was like first 2 months. So remember, I graduated in August. I'm telling you this timeline because I suffered the worst 5 months of my journey in this time. So I graduated in August and I started applying for like every possible thing. September again, I got this great opportunity by Paul Stewart. They wanted to hire me again as the e-commerce coordinator, and I again did not have my card until October, and no company is gonna wait even for 1 month so that you can get a card. You are lucky if your company waited for you for that long. None of my fashion companies did, so I lost that thing also. So this was like applying for LinkedIn and Indeed, never realizing there is an entire spectrum, especially for fashion people. There are like agencies with HR agencies that you don't have to pay money to just be enrolled with them. The companies actually pay them. Another thing which was like a huge shocker for me, and nobody ever told me when I was like applying for college or when I was even studying, is that almost every entry-level job in fashion is always going to be like a temp to perm role. That means hire you on a temporary basis for like say 3 months or 6 months or whatever they're needed. They will test you out if you are suitable for the company, if you're good, and then they will offer you a permanent job. It's not that I wasn't hearing back from these companies. I was hearing back. My date of my OBD card was like October 31st, which was the last date, and it passed. Now was the time for November. November was the first month when I started actually questioning myself, cracking bit by bit, and that was also the time I started actually looking at the agencies and I started applying for like jobs. I know it took me 3 months to get in my head that I should not just apply for like marketing positions and e-commerce positions, but also apply for other positions through these agencies. I kid you not, I have interviewed with Versace, I interviewed with Oscar de la Renta, and of course, like, I did not get hired because I couldn't start my job. That was the time where like the God was like, okay, I'm gonna throw every challenge at you and let's see how you deal with it. December first week was literally the first time I called my parents. I've like cried for hours straight. Like I was almost on the verge, but my parents and my friends, Tanvi and Akshay, Arusha, even like those three people, such a solid rock for me during this time, because I would have cried and left everything and would have just gone home. Was it not for them listening to me non-stop for hours of how pissed I am? And it was finally the third week of December when I got my EAD card, and by that time no company was hiring, because that's like Christmas, so like no company is hiring, there are no interviews happening. I have just 3 months, that time till March third week to get a job. It's like December, so I was applying for any and every possible job. Together I was working with like seven different agencies for somebody to just like hire me. And I was like, maybe this is not the thing for me. Maybe I'm not set to work for a company. And as you all know, in the last week of December was when I started my own YouTube channel. I posted my first video. It's like so nervous, but you know when something just feels right in your gut, like you just know it's right for you, and putting your work out in the universe. I'm so grateful for you guys. After that, everything just changed. It's like I found my path and now God is gonna give me every other thing. Got a call from this company that I had applied for in December for the social media strategist role. Call from them on like Jan 1st, and I was already employed by Jan 7th, and I started working with them. Come third week, I just knew in my gut, like, this is not the company for me. I started to hear, like, the company is going through some shifts. Last week of January, the first week of February was when I was laid off by the company. In that first week of February, I had also got a call from my current company, Uniqlo. If I was still looking for an opportunity, and I was like, if I get this role, I am leaving this company. So I was like, yes, I'm still looking for this opportunity and I want to be with the company. I got a call on Wednesday that, okay, you can come in for an interview. On Friday, I was laid off. This call from Uniqlo, if this was not gonna happen to me. Like, destiny is so, like, wicked and cruel, and it just, like, turns you upside down and, like, just makes you go through, like, the roughest patch before giving you, like, the best thing. And till date, I have been with Uniqlo for, like, more than a year now, and I feel so lucky to be with a company that not only, like, understands you, but, like, the people that I work with. I'm not exaggerating, but they are literally, like, the best people. This is, like, the end of my three-part series of my master's journey. That entire process of 5 months where I was questioning myself pushed me out of my comfort zone. If you are in a position right now where you're going through that storm in your life, or, like, a storm that's always rainbow, there's anything that you want to tell me, please let me know in the comments down below. If not, meet me on my Instagram as well. I would love to just, like, talk and help in any way possible. So that is it for today's video, guys. Hope you enjoyed this three-part series, and thank you for this idea, Akshay. I give you, like, a little bit of sneak peek of what's going to be expected for the next. Let me know if you still want me to continue this trend of, like, showing you what's going to happen in the next episode. I would love to start filming that way as well. Don't forget to like this video, share this video with a friend who is going through OPT, share this video with an international student as well, particularly who's, like, applying for OPT, going to graduate soon, or already graduated, because this might help them understanding that even if it takes 5 months to get your OPD, when the right company comes, it's just gonna work out. Don't forget again to subscribe to my channel, because I post new videos every single Friday, and I will see you guys in the next videos. I know these videos were, like, really information heavy, so I hope you guys have taken a lot of notes, but next video is a very fun video, and it's gonna be with a special person on my channel. I'm very excited for this video. I hope you guys are excited too for the next one. And I will see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Till then, bye.